Hi, I'm what you need. You're watching my video. If you like what you're seeing, don't forget you can comment, share, subscribe, and donate via Western Union or MoneyGram. So, Vasily Lomachenko said that Teofimo Lopez's height and reach was a problem for him in this fight when he fought Teofimo Lopez. Now, I want to show you guys something because height and reach becomes a problem if you know how to use them. All right? Jorge Linares is taller than Teofimo Lopez, and he's longer than Teofimo Lopez. Jorge Linares is 5'8" with a 69-inch reach. Teofimo Lopez is 5'7" with a 68.5-inch reach. Luke Campbell is taller than all of them. He's 5'9" with a 71-inch reach. Now, here's the thing. Jorge Linares was getting tagged up by Vasily Lomachenko. Luke Campbell, much taller than Teofimo Lopez, was getting tagged up as well, but not as much, okay? Much less. In fact, Luke Campbell was walking down Vasily Lomachenko in spots. So why is it that Teofimo Lopez was able to beat Lomachenko? He wasn't dropped, unlike Linares and Luke Campbell. And also, it wasn't as difficult a fight to face Jorge Linares and Luke Campbell as it was to face Teofimo Lopez, who was shorter and also just basically shorter than both of them, right? The reason is Teofimo Lopez was actually using specific footwork to maintain range, using his jab, staying behind his stick, as well as using the lead right hand and going to Lomachenko's body. So this is why Teofimo Lopez was most successful. Teofimo Lopez put away his jab and was not as much distance controlling Vasily Lomachenko as he was early on in the fight. So in rounds 8, 9, 10, 11. But of course he got headbutted in 8, 9 to 10. His father told him and instructed him to use his forearm to keep Lomachenko from coming in by his head. He still got headbutted. Teofimo Lopez has a long way to go still. Okay, his defense is not bad, but he still needs to be able to have better defense with the shell on the back foot. He did block a lot of Loma's punches though, and slip them and unroll them and all of that stuff. So Teofimo Lopez was able to deal with Vasily Lomachenko because he prevented him from getting weak side access. Lomachenko tried his best using head movement, trying to feint to come in to sort of catch Teofimo Lopez off guard with his jab as well as his footwork to get to the inside. So he made himself small, changed levels, and then he tried to rotate around Teofimo Lopez because that was his bread and butter move, like I told you. And Teofimo Lopez knows that and is that. So there were various ways they did to offset him. One was circling to his right. The other way was, or what we call anti-clockwise. The other way was just simply distance control. If Vasily Lomachenko took two steps backward, he'd take two steps forward. Of course, there was a lot more to it than that, from the swivel movement to the feints to come inside to the precise footwork you see with Canelo Alvarez when he's walking down his opponents. So you feint and you keep that sort of offbeat tempo coming in, as well as several other things. Now, I was listening to Joel Diaz, who seemed to be very clueless, or he was pretending to be very clueless because he's a trainer. He should know better. And he was saying how Teofimo Lopez looked like he was trying to make the fight, whereas Vasily Lomachenko wasn't trying to make the fight. Lomachenko was trying to make the fight, and he was trying to find the angles to get to the inside. He was trying to get his head off center line so he wouldn't get hit by Teofimo Lopez. But Vasily Lomachenko has to go forward to mount his offense. There's no other way he does it. He does not fight off the back foot. He does not catch and counter. He doesn't do any of those things. His thing is using angles and slipping punches or dipping from punches and getting to the inside. So this is what Vasily Lomachenko does, okay? So as Teofimo Lopez so correctly said, he does not fight off the back foot. He does not fight going backward. Okay, so that's basically it for Teofimo Lopez versus Vasily Lomachenko. And the excuse that Lomachenko says, he's very long and he has height and reach. He's actually the shortest of all the guys that you faced, Lomachenko. The thing about it is how he utilized it, how he used it, the intelligence, the ring IQ that he had, and the smarts that he had in this fight to flip the script on you. So yeah, you were outplayed in every single kind of way by Teofimo Lopez in this fight. But kudos to you, you had a heart of gold and you decided you was going to have to take some firepower to get in there, and you tried to make a fight of it. You caught Teofimo Lopez with one good body shot. People talking about a lot of body shots. It's just one good body shot you caught Teofimo Lopez in this fight. He stunned you several times, and he actually hurt you to the body several times, as you do know. The problem with it was, Lomachenko, that he wasn't going to the body enough, but I understand. If you try to go to the body, you expose your head to get hit to the head. And Teofimo Lopez, he hits you, he stuns you. So I got what Lomachenko was trying to do. I understand why he had to bully his way in by tucking his chin, keeping his head down, and coming in hard. Kind of a la Bernard Hopkins. So I understood everything that he was doing in that fight. But Teofimo Lopez always had an answer for him. And that's the reason why Lopez solved the matrix. I'm going to catch you guys later. Peace.